He was in the hall as well, and he's put together his own focus group of, as I understand it, 15 undecided voters from 7 different swing states. There's nobody we'd rather have on this sort of subject, Frank, than you. You do it so well. We have Jeanne Zaino and Rick Davis joining us as well. So, Frank, give us the initial answer. I'm not saying it's necessarily the final answer. What did your focus group tell you?
Focus group told me that Chris Wallace was the winner in trying to control the two debaters, that America was the loser, quite frankly. And I know that this is going to upset everyone. It's going to upset your colleagues. It's going to upset supporters of both campaigns. But the fact is, this was the most disruptive, aggressive, rude. I don't have the thesaurus to give you all the words that were going through my swing voter group. People were really mad at what was happening. I wanted to do this conversation right here because I wanted to capture what was going on. And the audience was stunned in this room. Didn't matter whether you were supporting Joe Biden or Donald Trump. They were shocked about what was happening. They were agitated about it. They thought that neither candidate behaved well. Joe Biden telling Donald Trump to shut up. My God. That has never happened in American politics. Think about that. Or Donald Trump interrupting and interrupting and interrupting and not stopping. So I got to tell you that people are leaving this hall really disillusioned. My focus group was really disappointed. And I'll tell you that the coverage you're going to get tonight, other than those who are highly and unfairly partisan, is that the public was really the loser of what happened this evening.
Hey, Frank, this is Rick Davis. It's good to see you. I hope you're doing well. I was also shocked by the outcome of this debate. And I'm curious, knowing where the race is today and realizing how stable this race has been over a long period of time, did you see anything with the groups today that would have indicated even a negative reaction to Trump people not liking the way Trump reacted, Biden people not liking the way Biden reacted? I mean, did you get a sense that anything is going to get unraveled by this, or was it just a hot mess?
It was a hot mess. And what I got the sense of is that I've been saying all along we're going to have the highest turnout we've ever had, that everyone is going to participate. Some people are going to participate two or three times. Dead people are coming back to vote. I don't believe that anymore. Actually, what was happening in my session was that people were telling me that they're not going to participate, that they're not going to vote, that neither candidate. In fact, it's not that neither candidate won their votes, it's that both candidates lost the right to appeal to them. Please make no mistake. We're not asking for beanbag. We're not asking people to be polite to each other and reasonable with each other. They were just looking for a vision of the future. And what they got is this snarky attack back and forth, and an unwillingness to play by the rules, an unwillingness to listen to each other, which is exactly what the American people have been complaining about for the last 4 years. Well, they got it in spades. I mean, you've got the session behind me. I would have thought that people would have stayed around, talked to each other, enjoyed themselves. This room, and I'll show you if you can see all the way around here, this room is almost vacant now. People just felt that they had to get out because it was so bad.
Frank, it's really good. I've been waiting to talk to you all night. It's Jeanne Zaino to see what did these undecided voters think, and you just described it, and I'm frightened to hear it. But did you get a sense from any of these undecided voters that they would engage at all in the upcoming two debates? Because some of the chatter we're hearing online is, should the next few debates even go forward at this point? This thing was so distressing to so many people. And of course, you just said that it sounds like many of these people may just not participate in the vote at all at this point.
I'm going to give you four words, and I don't think you're going to get in trouble with the FCC over this, but I'm not sure. To hell with it, was their reaction. And they both initially went to their camps. Those who were undecided but leaning Republican liked that Donald Trump came out strong. Those who were undecided and leaning with Biden liked the fact that he was more calm, cool, and collected. But as this went on, the anger and the disappointment and the sadness, I got people that are telling me in their communication that they're crying, that they were so upset over what's happening. I urge those people viewing tonight not to see this as a contest between a Republican or Democrat or Joe Biden versus Donald Trump. This is a contest for the soul of the country and whether or not we can have a proper election, a proper discussion over the last 30, 35 days of this campaign. And the conclusion from these undecided voters is that we are so torn apart, so unwilling to pay respect to each other, at least these candidates are, that that they're throwing up their hands and saying, no mas, I give up.
So, Frank, I'm always trying to find some upside to some of this someplace. You've spent a career not just analyzing polls, putting together focus groups, but advising political campaigns. If you were advising either campaign tonight, given what you've just said, what would you tell them to do to try to turn this around for their candidate?
I love that question. For Joe Biden, he's got to be stronger, which actually means he has to lean into the microphone. Now, I don't know how it sounded at home because I was here in the hall, but Biden was so soft that he almost disappeared, except when he lost his temper. And Joe Biden's best line in the evening, or best argument of the evening, is when he talked about his son, Beau, and what his son had sacrificed. That is where Joe Biden did his best. Donald Trump was clearly prepared. The rumor was that he never went through traditional debate prep. I saw someone who was completely prepared, over-aggressive, over-insulting, over-interrupting, and that I tell him that you cannot have coffee for at least 48 hours before the debate to chill out a little bit. Don't jump over everything. But you know what? Neither Joe Biden or Donald Trump would listen to debate prep. Then we've got two candidates that believe that they know how to do it on their own. And the American people saw what they saw tonight. I know with my dials, I know if I was using them, that the lines would have been going straight down and that the level of frustration, disappointment, if not anger, with how much Chris Wallace had to get in and just separate these candidates. This was not a UFC fight. This was just a brawl, a global brawl.